Welcome back to Vlogmas, Shalligators. We have got a special story time today about my breakup. Ah! Just in time for the holidays. I am single as can be. And you know what? I'm psyched about it. I'm going to tell you why. Yeah, Gavin and I have called it quits. Well, I have called it quits on him because I was just at the end of my tether. And one thing I realized that I wanted to pass on to you guys is just because something isn't an F doesn't mean it's an A+. Relationships are not pass fail, not for me anyway. And while this relationship was like a B-, I'm not a B- student, unless we're talking about organic chemistry. I'm an A+er, and that's what I want from my relationships, and it didn't meet the standard. And I'm gonna tell you exactly what I said. I'm gonna show you the text message and why and what happened and all this shit. So we're gonna get into it. But before we do, if you wanna talk to me one-on-one about a breakup or a guy or a dog or a guinea pig or anything like that, find me on my website, shallonlester.com, and click submit a question. Also, get a video from me, a custom video via Cameo. Head on over there. It's a great gift for a friend if you don't know what to get them, and I give it to you in just a few days, so it can be a good last minute kind of gifty kind of thing. Also, shop my SLXO clothing collection for some fun new drip for the fun new year. I guess that's about it. Okay. So Gavin, okay, if you guys don't remember, Gavin and I met on like an app. We met on a dating app. I can't even remember which one. And we were chatting for a while, and I knew he was in medicine, and turns out he was, when I was in the hospital, he was like, he knew about my case and he was like checking in on me via the nurses. And it was really, really cute. And it was like a Hallmark movie, meet cute. And I know you guys are really excited about it. And I was too, because, you know, it's always fun when we meet someone in kind of an unusual way. I mean, I know we met on the app, but like we had that other connection. And it's even more special when something really amazing, especially love, comes out of a disaster scenario, which being in the hospital for 5 days clearly was. You know, I mean, that's like, that's the plot line of the movie Speed, right? That's like the plot line of everything, of Titanic. It's like, found love in a hopeless place, right? And so I was really excited to hang out with him and get to know each other. And the first few weeks were really fun. Sort of. We had a date, we had our first date, and we had an amazing time, and then he worked. Like, he works, like, chunks of time in a row. Not, like, it's not Monday through Friday. He'll work, you know, over weekends or whatever, because he's in medicine. And he worked, like, 5 days in a row, and I didn't hear from him for a week. And I was like, that's odd, because I feel like we had a really great time, and, like, a good kiss and everything like that, but I don't know, apparently not, because he's, like, kind of ghosting out. But then, like, when he was done working, he was all up in my pieces again. And he's like, yeah, like, I've just been at work. And I was like, can you not text someone while you go to work? Like, everyone has a job. Okay. And it just goes to show, the first fight is the last fight. The first red flag is the ultimate red flag. Because we've been seeing each other a few weeks now. Like, quite a few. I don't know, since October or something. Yeah. Like, not constantly, but like we're dating, we're hanging out and sleeping together and dating and talking about stuff in the future. And he told me he had an 8-day stretch at work coming up. And I should have said this out loud. I should have said this. I know what's going to happen. Gavin, you're not going to talk to me for all those days that you're at work. I'm going to assume you're ghosting me. I'm going to go fucking ballistic. I'm going to dump you. You're not going to understand why. Guess what happened? Exactly that fucking happened. And I should have said it out loud, because then maybe he would have been forewarned and forearmed that, like, hey, just because you're going to work like 8 to 5, like most people do, doesn't mean you cannot talk to the chick you're dating and sleeping with. Once we're sleeping together, like, you need to act kind of a different way. Like, you have a little bit more responsibility here. You don't just get to, like, brush it off. Now, listen, I would not have been so pissed off about this, because at the end of the day, I felt good about it. I didn't feel great. Like, I was always like, he's great. I don't think he's my forever, but I'm having a really great time getting to know him and hanging out with him. Okay. I wouldn't be so pissy about this if he hadn't gone on a rant. We talked about this in the video about how to get people to shut the fuck up and stop talking. Went on a mostly unsolicited rant about his ex-girlfriend and how she ghosted him after like years. And it was clear to me that she was like kind of a con artist, you know, like, and I don't think he could see that. And I don't think he will see that maybe ever, because I'm sure she'll be back. Like people like that always come back around. But like he went on this rant about ghosts. He's like, it's never okay to ghost someone. Never. And I'm like, well, I mean, I've gone on like a Tinder date with someone and like not talked to them again. Or I've definitely slept with someone and never talked to them again. He's like, no, no, that's not okay either. You should at least be an adult enough to send a text to someone if you're not into it. I'm like, okay, damn. So when he went 7 days without talking to me, 8 days, how do you think that went? Would you like to know? Okay, here's the text. This is the text I sent to him. I don't have it in front of me, but I'm pretty sure I can recite it from memory right now. Because I texted him and I was like, it's never okay to ghost someone ever. You. Like a quote attributed to him. He sends me back a picture of a keyboard. It's not like a picture of like your finger on like the nukes ready to launch. Like it's a keyboard. Okay, we all use them. He's like, wish I was doing something fun. I'm just working and sleeping. That's a non sequitur response. Like, what is that? What are you talking? You're answering a question I didn't ask you, which to me is gaslighting. You're gaslighting me. Like, I didn't say you were doing something fun. I don't care what you're doing. I don't care if you're putting out fires, if you're hosting a gay cabaret. I don't care. You need to be communicating with the person you're dating if you want me to still be around. Call me crazy. And so I was not going to take that bait. And again, I knew what he was doing. It's like, well, I'm at work. And I said, Gavin, you're not excused from basic decency because you have a job. Everyone has a job. Jeff Bezos has a job and a girlfriend. Barack Obama even has a wife. I have a job myself. Several, in fact. Not that you fucking care, but we'll get to that in a minute. And I still make time for the people I care about. And it's especially disappointing that you're ghosting me, considering your unsolicited rants about how much you hate it. And there's nothing more beta than a man who holds a woman to a standard he can't meet. I don't settle because I don't have to. I'm too accomplished and I'm whole on my own. So as much as I've enjoyed our time together, and I meant that, this hasn't met my standard. I'm moving on. I feel good about this. Well, it's a shame. I feel wistful and just, it's like, that's a bummer. Did he respond? I don't know because I blocked him. Petty. I know that that's petty. But look, when you're in an emotional situation, you get gassed up. It's like you can't not take the bait. And I knew he was going to respond with something gaslighty, telling me I'm crazy. I'm at work.
Oh, you're at work? Whoa. Do you have a job?
You're not 13. You're Oliver Twist. Everyone has a job. This isn't like this grand achievement that you support yourself and you're an adult. Like, you're in your 30s. Of course you have a job. Like, oh, you know who didn't have a job? Your ex didn't have a job. So is that why it's unusual to you? Is that why? Because she was always just waiting there like a sim because she had nothing better to do except for con you out of a green card? Got it. That's not me. That's not me. So I felt good that I took the reins instead of being like, well, okay, or just getting pissy and giving someone another chance. Because again, this shit's not pass fail. You're getting graded and B's get degrees, D's get degrees. They don't get this girl. Okay? It's A plus or it's nothing because I'm an A plus girlfriend. I would invite him out. He was on drugs. He couldn't leave the house. I'm like, okay. You know, he wasn't taking an interest in my life. We talked about that in the video about chatty people. I think I have a fairly interesting life. I mean, at the very least, the things I do in any given day are not what most girls in Montana are doing, you know? Like, I don't know. I thought maybe it was kind of interesting. People sort of listen to me talk for a living. I must be a little bit interesting if I'm a successful YouTuber. I don't know about that. But he just, there was no real depth of interest. And I'm sorry, that's a deal breaker to me. If you can't be interested in the good things that are happening, the fluffy, neat thing, the auditions and the business deals and whatever, how are you going to be when I have a bad day, when things aren't going well, when I really need someone to pull up for me and listen as I pour my heart out and I need your advice and what do you think? And you're just like, LOL, IDK, BRB. You know, what even is this and why am I wasting my time on it? I meant what I said. I am whole on my own. And it's funny how once you put it into writing, you're like, that's true. I am. I really believe this. Like, you realize how true it is. And if it doesn't feel true, who the fuck cares? Say it anyway, and then go make it true. Go make it true. So, we're single for the holidays. And I feel relieved. Because now that I am more whole on my own, and I've done that through work and like practice and making it a priority to craft a life that I love and friends who are there for me, it's like, it's not a loss. It's just like a bummer. It's a bummer. And it's like, I think we could have been something really good. Like we were talking about writing songs together and doing all this stuff because he's super musical. And I always thought that was really awesome. But it's like, hey man, if you're not checking all these other boxes, you can't only check one. You might think it's a bigger box to check, but it's not. So look, I feel, yeah, like wistfully sort of bummed out, but relieved. I'm going into the holidays unbothered. I'm not going in there like, well, what is he going to get me? And am I going to meet his family? And blah, 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 blah. I don't care. I just don't care. You know, I would rather be whole, a closed circuit on my own, not having to shop and not having to be disappointed further down the line. My birthday's in January and then Valentine's Day. Like, do I need to hold space for this person if they're already just B minus? And I think what it is, I think he is an incredible person, but I don't think he's over his ex-girlfriend. And it's like, and I said that to him when he was going on this rant about her. And I'm like, I really don't think you're over her, because you're talking about her with great intensity, and the opposite of love isn't hate, it's apathy. You know how I know that? I do this for a living. Not that you care, but I do this for a living. And he's like, oh, I'm sorry. Should I not have told you all this? And I'm like, no, you should tell me, but you should have told it to me 45 minutes ago before we slept together, because I would not have slept with you tonight had I known that this is where you were emotionally with your ex. And he's like, oh, I feel bad. I feel bad. And it's like, I don't care how you feel. I'm aware of how you feel. This is me. We're talking about me and how I feel now. I don't care. This isn't your place to feel bad. This is my place to feel bad. I've already cornered that market. So thanks. It was just, there was a lot of good. There was a lot of good. We had a lot of fun. We were together. We laughed a lot. He was very interesting. He was very lively and passionate. And I loved that. But B minus. I only want A. I don't need anybody else. I'm not desperate. I'm not lonely. I'm certainly not burdened by an influx and a surplus of free time at all. I have so little time. And I know you guys don't either have a ton of time. So like, what are we doing? Where the fuck are we spending our time? With someone who's a B minus? Why are you lowering the bar like that? Are you a B minus girlfriend? If you are, well, okay. Sometimes we are, and some of us are. I bet you're not though. I bet you're an A plus friend, an A plus sister, A plus daughter, A plus alligator. So why are you okay with an A minus guy? I'm not. And to take forward action to demonstrate that, be like, this hasn't met my standard, I'm moving on, felt so good. It felt so good. And one of my friends is like, well, did you actually dump him? Because I kind of think he was dumping you because he hadn't talked to you for 8 days. It's like, thank you. Thank you. But I'm going to spin this to my favor. I don't think he thought he was doing anything wrong. I think he thought he was going to get done with this block of work and I was just going to be right there like the sim. And it's like, no, I don't wait around like this. I don't have to. Guys are so dumb when they ghost or when they do shit like this. It's like, listen, all you're doing is letting that post-sex oxytocin drain completely out of me. And what's left is the very harsh reality of who you are. And me having a lot of time to think back on our dates and think back on the times you interrupted me or didn't ask about that audition or whatever. And it's like, let me just get out my red pen and regrade this assignment. I don't think it's even a B minus. Guys give us enough room to look around and see our options and see our dissatisfaction. And it's like, huh. And you thought I'd just be waiting? Do you have any idea who I am? Well, no, you don't. You don't even follow me on Instagram. Not like I care about like followers, you know, like, I'm, but I care about the person I'm sleeping with having an even surface level, social media level interest in my life. I don't think that that's like a big ask. You should, if you're fucking a girl, you should probably follow her on Instagram. We're good. We are good. No need to ask any questions. No real curiosity here. Okay. So yeah, no, I'm petty and I blocked and I don't know if he responded. And again, like, I don't care. I don't need to get drawn into a conversation. I don't need to have this like, you know, well, he said this and I'm going to write back. Mm-mm. Because it isn't a conversation. It isn't a dialogue. It's a statement. Baby boy, don't put a question mark where I've put a period. So that's my tale of medium woe. Not really woe. I honestly feel good and free. And it's like, I feel like I've spent so many Christmases brokenhearted or sad because I didn't have a boyfriend or disappointed because like the boyfriend wasn't pulling up and doing the right thing. It's like, this is the season of me being just unbothered. I don't want to deal with even like a ton of Christmas decorations. I don't want to deal with a boyfriend. I don't want to deal with a bunch of complicated trips. I don't even want to host parties. I was going to host this like crafternoon party with my friends. I'm like, I just don't even feel like it. It just sounds like a bother. And I just want to be unbothered. I want to have a relaxing, elegant, peaceful holiday. You know, I'm not sending Christmas cards. I'm not buying a ton of gifts. It's like, I just don't feel like it. And that's all right. It's not going to be like this forever. Maybe next Christmas, I'll be like, I'm going all out. Not just one boyfriend, 10. Not just one dog, 35. Like, maybe I'll just go absolutely berserk. Don't feel like it now. So listen to yourself. If that's where you're at, embrace it. It's not pathetic to be single at the holiday. It's unbothered. It's free. It's open to what the new year might bring. There's a whole new year ahead. There's a whole new season ahead. There's Valentine's Day, and then there's Easter. And both of those holidays involve a lot of chocolate. And that is what life is all about. Eating. Speaking of, I'm going to go bake some Christmas goodies. You know, I always post it on my Insta. Tell me if you guys are brokenhearted right now, because we can obviously do so many videos on being brokenhearted at Christmas. And there is one that's going to be coming up about how to deal with your first Christmas single after you've been in a relationship, which is very different than being single at Christmas when you're used to being single, you know? So we can do that video too, but tell me the topics you want and I will see you later. Shall the Gators. Merry, merry. Mwah!